Hi, it's Teresa from Dodge Nature Center. And dirt detectives, it's time to do some more investigating about rocks. I'm going to read you a wonderful book that's called Let's Go Rock Collecting. And it talks all about the different kinds of rocks there are. This is a book by Roma Gans, and it's illustrated by Holly Keller. So let's go rock collecting. People collect all kinds of things. They collect coins, stamps, baseball cards, shells, toys, bottles, pitchers, and cats. Some people collect things that are very old. The older, the better. The oldest things you can collect are rocks. Most of them are millions and millions of years old. Most kinds of rocks are easy to find, but some, like diamonds and emeralds, are rare. That's why they are valuable. Rocks cover the whole earth. No matter where you live on rock. There is rock under city streets and country farms. And there is rock under every ocean, lake, and river. The Romans built roads out of rocks. The roads are still used today. Things made with rock last and last. The rocks that make up the surface of the earth are called the earth's crust. Most of the crust is made of igneous rock. Igneous means made by heat. Inside the earth, it is very hot, hot enough to melt rock. The melted rock is called magma. Sometimes the magma pushes through cracks in the crust. When magma comes to the surface, it is called lava. The lava cools and becomes very hard. It becomes igneous rock. Most of the Earth's igneous rock comes from volcanoes on the seafloor. Granite is an igneous rock. It once was magma. Some granite is gray with small, shiny black and white crystals. Some granite has large pink, black, and white crystals. The crystals in granite are called quartz. Some pieces of quartz are white, like milk. Others are clear, like glass. Sometimes quartz has bands of many colors. Jewelry is made from it. The marbles you play with may have been made of banded quartz. Basalt is another kind of igneous rock. It is usually dark in color, gray, green, or black. It is the most common of all igneous rocks. Not all rocks are hard. Some rocks are soft. Talc is so soft you can pinch it into a powder with your fingers. Talc is number one on a scale for hardness of rocks. The scale is called Mohs scale of hardness, and it goes from 1 to 10. Quartz is number 7. Diamonds are number 10. They are the hardest rocks in the world. Each mineral on the scale can scratch the mineral below it. A fingernail has a hardness of about 2.5, so your fingernail can leave a scratch in talc, but not in calcite. Not all rocks are igneous rocks. Some are made of sediments. Sandstone is one kind of sedimentary rock. It is made of grains of sand, mud, and pebbles. Millions of years ago, sand was blown into rivers. The rivers carried the sand along and dropped it into lakes or oceans. Layer after layer settled on the bottom of the lakes and seas. The top layers pressed down on the bottom layers. Slowly, the lower layers of sand became stone. You'll know sandstone when you see it. It is often soft and grainy. Rub it with your fingers, and grains of sand may come off. Another sedimentary rock is limestone. It is made of the shells of animals that lived millions of years ago. Most often, limestone is white, but it can be pink, tan, or other colors. Sometimes you can see the outlines of shells in limestone. Limestone is used to make cement. Cement is then mixed with sand, gravel, and water to make concrete for sidewalks. 5,000 years ago, the Egyptians built the pyramids out of limestone. They are still standing. Maybe someday you'll go to Egypt and see them. Besides igneous and sedimentary rocks, there is a third kind of rock in the Earth's crust. It is called metamorphic. Metamorphic means changed. Slate is a metamorphic rock. Slate was once shale, but over millions of years, tons and tons of rocks pressed on it. The pressure made the shale very hot, and the heat and pressure changed it into slate. Most slate is gray, but some is black, red, or brown. Other metamorphic rocks are made the same way slate is, by heat and pressure. Some metamorphic rocks are so changed, you can't tell what they once were. Granite can turn into gneiss. It once was a piece of gray granite. Now it is darker gray, and its crystals have separated into layers. Limestone turns into marble. Some marble has colored marks that look like clouds. Sandstone turns into quartzite. It may still look like sedimentary sandstone, but now it is much harder. When you start collecting rocks, you'll find out how many different varieties there are. One way to start a collection is to look for rocks of different colors. You'll find there are pink rocks, black rocks, and pure white ones. There are gray rocks and brown and yellow ones. See if you can tell what kind of rocks they are. You can keep your small rocks in egg cartons. You can keep larger ones in cardboard boxes with dividers, like this one. Rock collecting is fun, and one of the best things about it is that you can do it anywhere. Wherever you go, try to find new rocks and add them to your collection. The end. Well, thanks for reading along with this book that's all about rock collecting. Join us for another distance learning lesson from Dodge Nature Center. Bye!